CLI Night with Night Jiu-Jitsu, and I'm here with
Jared Jessup back in Jiu-Jitsu.
And we're going to talk about, recently I released a video on arm lock finishes. And so once you get in position for the arm lock, how do you finish it? So we're going to kind of look at the opposite of that, which are arm lock defenses. So now, arm lock defenses, just like any submission defense, you're late in the game. This is kind of a Hail Mary thing. These are not your, should be your standard. You should be preventative and not get yourself in that position. But once you get there, you still want to have some last minute, some last second kind of late escapes. And that's what this is going to kind of focus on. So Jared has set this up. This could have been from mounting, side control, some other position, but we wind up in this basic kind of a spider web arm lock finishing position like this. So one of the first ones here is, first I need to probably try to pull this onto safety. He got here, but I want to try to rescue this arm, pull it back. If I had something to grab onto, I could grab material here maybe to anchor it. Now, once I pull this back, I'd like to try to get this elbow down here so that he can't really lock good underneath both my arms. And then I can go here with some kind of connection, either gable grip or S grip here, and I can use this to knock this knee off of my head. Now, I don't want to leave my face straight up and rip my nose off. Instead, I'm going to turn my face away from him. And then, like from here, I'm going to dig my heels in, lift my hips, and pull my butt down toward my feet as I hit up this way. Once that happens here, now I want, from this position here, I want to pull this underneath my head and my head on top of the leg here and start to shoulder walk out this way. Once I get to a certain position, I want some weight on the leg so he doesn't pop right back up to mount position. Drop my elbow to the floor, retract this leg underneath like I'm doing a technical stand up, and then wind up probably inside his guard here, which is not a great position for me, but it's a huge upgrade considering I was just stuck in an arm lock.
So that one Eli just did, that could work if the feet are crossed or not crossed. So let's look at if I can almost use it like a rear naked choke type defense. So my hand goes in the bicep and my other hand's gonna shoot all the way through it. It goes like just like I put the rear naked choke off. You're saying so my hands go like this, right? This I always want to make sure that the arm that he's trying to submit is being contained. I'm making a structure around that. So boom, hand goes on top and it shoots right next to my neck. Now when the leg comes over, I'm gonna hook. So I got a hook here and a hook here. So I see there's a pull, it ends up lifting up on his own leg. This can be a little bit tricky because I want to slide my arm out of this this kind of space right here. I want to make this into a hole that I can slide my arm out of. So as I've got the grip, I'm gonna scoot down again. I set my boot so I can Eli cover it down slightly. And then I'm gonna put the weight on Eli's tailbone. Because one thing that makes the arm lock powerful is if the heels and shoulders on the mat, you can raise the hips through the arm to hyperextend it. So I want to take that ability away by shifting weight onto his tailbone. Now that I've made a little hole right here. So I'm gonna loop the hand out, this is the most dangerous part. I'm kind of giving it to him for a brief moment. I turn the palm out, right? And then I'm gonna walk my hips towards his shoulders and my head away and bring my elbow back to the ground, okay? From here, as I go to get up, I can put this hand down and start moving up around this way, but I don't wanna come back through here because I might cut and try and or put it on watch something like that. So boom, boom, hand comes here. I shift the weight back to it and come through. You see?
Generally speaking, the way you can kind of categorize a lot of these is shallow or deep. You're either making it more shallow so you can pull free, or it's you're pressing in deeper so you can kind of push through the other side. I tend to refer to this as the fishhook principle, the fishhook concept, because the idea is if you get a fishhook stuck in your hand, if it's shallow, it's not quite barbed deep yet, you just pull it right back out. If it's barbed deep, you have to like push it through to the other side and clip the barb off, or push it all the way out and take it all the way through. So the same kind of thing applies whenever you have a barb in a submission. So the barb in this case would be the elbow a lot of the times when we're talking about arm locks. So another one I'm gonna look at here that may be like for if it's deep here like this, and this is a really bad one because what's happening here is he's got the arm exposed. I haven't been able to pull it back to rescue to go to here like Jared was talking about, or to even to here to this S grip, and so he's already extending it. Now make sure that when you're doing this one here that this is definitely a Hail Mary and it's not your go-to, which I see a lot of people go directly to this one, and I think it's not a great idea because this is a very dangerous one. So we're going to do the hitchhiker escape. The way we do the hitchhiker escape is I want to make like a shaka symbol here like this, which you should be familiar with if you do jiu-jitsu. So and as he like unfolds this arm here, I'm going to go pinky up, thumb down. I want to take this hand and pull the top leg down here if I can get my elbow tight, and that's good. I don't have to make a ton of space, just enough to loosen my head, look away from the arm lock. I'm going to kick this one out here at this like perpendicular to my body here, and I want to kick this one up and over as much as I can to this position. I want to keep this one held as much as I can too, is so that whenever I come back up, I'm not walking myself right up into a triangle.
Yeah.
scoop out to the other side, and then I should wind up in some kind of cross-eyed position up here by Jared's hip so that he can't really replace the triangle either. One of the things you run into whenever you're doing this hitchhiker, sometimes you can smash your face as you walk around. So one thing that will help prevent that from happening is letting the shoulder that's caught come over the other shoulder. So that shoulder's going deep, and then as one shoulder goes over the other shoulder, it gives my head space to come through so I'm not smashing my face, right? Then I can clamp the leg and slide through.
One that's pretty easy to make shallow, and this is whenever the guy goes in and he's got one leg over, one leg tucked. And this is kind of a speed arm lock. This is maybe right off the throw, and you step one leg over and go straight for the lock right here. So it offers less control, but there are definitely times that you need to try to hit like this. So what I'm talking about here is that Jared has thrown one leg over and he's going right back for this spring up. So what I would like to try to do is, as much as I can, I want to rescue this, and the S-grip usually suffices. And the thing about this here is that whenever he starts to pull back, he's going to help me change the angle of my body. Now I need to come all the way up on my shoulders like I'm doing a full body kind of lift here. And then I want to try to get the back of my hips, the small of my back, to land on the inside of Jared's knee. So as he's pulling here like this, and I raise up, then I'm going to pull myself out this direction, and I should land right in this kind of cross-eyed position like that.
Let's say he's got me in the arm lock and his feet arm crossed. So here I can make the S-grip again on the table. But if I've got the space right here, sometimes I can drop this elbow down to the ground. And if the elbow makes it down to the ground, then I can raise my hips to push the heel up over my forearm. Now once that's happened, I can bring both legs up and come over. Now right here, I want to make sure I can get my legs above the knee, cross the ankles, and straighten. And that makes this whole area open up. Now I go palm up, bring my elbow back to the mat. Okay? Right here, I'm going to keep one arm inside so it doesn't need to go through our arm for a knee lock. Right? Right? And you can come up here and get similar to a scrape right here. Alright, so another option right here is if he's landed in the arm lock and he's got both feet to the north side of my shoulders. Right? And so if this happens, I want to secure the arm. Of course, I want to make a structural hip thing. Now I'm going to turn my palm out. Right? And go down kind of towards my hip. I walk my hips towards Eli's shoulders and my head away, right? And then from here, I'm gonna turn and look, and that's gonna allow me the freedom to start to roll out, almost like I'm passing the guard or something. And then from here, I can start getting that elbow to the mat.
So if we back this up to like this kind of technical mount, wherever he's about to go over and set up the armbar this way, I know he has to shift the weight this way to make this leg light enough to get over in front of my face like that to finish the arm lock. So whenever I feel that weight shift like that here, I want to change the angle of the weight shift so that it makes him off balance, and then it gives me space to be able to pull out. So as he's leaning this way here, that leg's starting to come over. I'm going to lean there, make him step, and then I'm going to be able to turn and pull my arm free like this here. Now, I can dive hands underneath here like this and come up on, so both my arms are outside, and I'll have to sit right up into a triangle position like that. So we get in this position here. He's already hooked me up here. He's got the leg over. He's shifting the weight. So as the leg starts to come over, I'm going to bump that weight and make him place his foot on the floor prematurely so he never gets the full cover that he needs to finish the arm lock. And then I'm able to turn the angle here, get my arm back out. And then from there, we can scramble and get back up. And I'm going to free up the arm lock situation.
Yeah. Hey, guys, so these are some really helpful arm lock defenses. I hope that you got some good details out of these. Again, this is not like a completely comprehensive list. And these are only the ones from bottom position, not even talking about what happens if he's attacking from the guard or from back mount or whatever. So we'll take a look at that in other videos. And in the meantime, keep watching the Night Jiu-Jitsu channel. Check out those arm lock finishes before, and check out Jared where at.
IQJiu.com as well as Facebook.
So, all right. Thanks, guys.